Try and get that chest to back, get that chin ripped. Hold on, go. If you end up in a situation like this, you need to know how to escape. What we're going to look at, because this is the last module, is the most common. First being the ground and pound. Right, so like I said before, monkey see, monkey do. You know, now it's not uncommon for somebody to take somebody down to the ground, get on top and start beating them. One, because they're trained to do it, or two, because they've seen it done. Right? So if you end up in that situation, understand how you're going to get there. Usually you're tackled. So the guy will shoot low. So we pick up one leg or both legs. Double leg takedown, pick up, drag, whatever. You're on your arms. Now he's got a position on top. Whether he knows anything about grappling or not, go right back to the schoolyard. You know? In my day, you'd have a stroke around the back and everybody would be around in a circle, including the fucking teachers. And you would like have a proper kick off and it was always the same. One was on top or one was underneath. Usually the one that was underneath would get a bit replaced in. But even though we knew nothing, you all do is hold the neck and pound the head. It's instinct. Do you understand that? So ground and pound has become similar now. The enemy's changing. Modern enemy's changing. So most people are training. So if you get taken down via a tackle, then you're going down. Understand the environment would be a lot more unforgiving than this. We've got forwards on an uneven set of steps and you could fucking fuck your spine for life. You know, so it's a dangerous place to be. Rather than get into the dynamics of taking you down right now, we're going to work off the idea that that's what the fuck happened, right? If somebody gets this position, here's the first thing. Imagine that I'm going down to the ground impactively hard with him on top. Who's sustaining all the impact?
You.
Right, I am. And it's not going to be like this. Here's the first thing. The first thing you've got to learn to do is default. Which means that when any stimulus pushes me back and off the basis of balance, my chin automatically drops, my shoulders shrug, and my hands come up. Right? This is the default. If I do this, boom, bang, I've already done his work. So I understand that when you hit this, it'll be unforgiving. Wind will be out of you. You'll be disrupted in breathing, see? Right? So from here, when he recognises immediate dominance, the second that we just come up a bit, the second that we land here, if I could just start and fight back, I could get him off. Do you understand? But what's more instinctual is, first of all, your recovery. So the first thing is you're going to be bewildered. And in that split second, he's going to realise the position of dominance that he's got, and he's going to go to guns. If he lands that, you're out. Mm-hmm. So you've got to cover your head. So when you cover your head, you might even move it, particularly when he's throwing multiple shots. At no point now can I take away this caged cover to try and hit him, because we'll exchange. So I need to use the premise of the principle of closest weapon to nearest target. Closest weapon I have available here is one or both elbows. The only trajectory I have which will safely keep me covered is downward, which means I'm going to target his groin or his pelvic bone, or inside peroneum. If he's throwing those bombs when he heals, boom, I'll bump him over, then he's going to get a reaction. First of all, I'm giving it pain here, or stimulus to think about, and then I'm bucking with my hips, which forces him to base. He doesn't base here, base plant. That's your job done. Right? But first of all, what you've got to get a feel of, get some pattern, is how this feels. You want to get desensitized to it. Right? So you're going to have 15 seconds, which is done to it. Okay? Well, I'll go 10 seconds. Right? So somebody count really fast, like. So as soon as I say, when you're going to throw shots at them, don't pit a pattern. Don't pit a pattern with the pads. Throw them like you punch. So punch with that, boom. Do you know what I mean? When you do a hook, slap with that hard. These pads are unforgiving. or forgiving rather. Imagine it in an MMA book. Imagine it in bare fists. The only saving grace you've got here is if I'm framing my hair and presenting you nothing but points and edges, you ain't got nothing pleasant to hit. Your fists are getting fucked up on me. Do you understand? Right, anyway, I'm waiting for you. Yeah. So don't get shit out of it, escape was, I dropped my elbows, bucked with my hips. That put his belly line in my face. If it could be negated by clothing, but it wasn't, it was very long, so I bit him. And when I bit him, he pulled away and recoiled. As he recoiled, I pushed. Do you understand? I could roll him off me and go the other way, or I could roll with him and take him down. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. First of all, I want you to feel what the onslaught feels like. So just that, nothing else. Get underneath your partner.
Fucking all the hips driving your feet, so literally you want to get a bridge like this. This is probably the only one shoulder, so I roll you. Do you understand?
What?
In order to create stimulus to do that, because he's such a big lump and he's focused here, if I just do that, I might get it and I might not. So I want to get, so what I'm going to do is take one elbow and just put drop it in your groin, or I'm going to do this one. Or I'm going to take both hands and use a coronal or a femoral nerve. And I just get a pattern interruption. So here is combative in the hard state. Here, boom, bang, bang, bang. So here we're going straight to the rear. Here we're going straight off the rear into the bike. But if I bucked him, he fell on me. Now I'm in danger, so I can bite and interrupt it. Do you understand? From here I can push him from this way, or I can roll. Yeah. So I want you to work the components. I've got this mount position, so in relation to a woman, because we're working on a specific woman, it's going around and to feel this bit. This. Two common assaults to a woman when she's been grounded from here will be she was slapped and beaten for, in order to ascertain dominance, so she capitulates, or she can be choked, which is a much more lethal thing. So understand, if somebody grabs you and gives you a fucking joint you're talking to, they're trying to intimidate. But if somebody, instead of grabbing your lapels, now grabs your neck, they're trying to close your airway. That's attempted murder. Mm-hmm. It's now potentially deadly force, because I could collapse her airway and not mean to, because I'm in an unsociable mood. Do you understand? So as soon as you get this is a real potential threat to life. So we're going to look at both of these. To start with, we're just going to look at dealing with this onslaught of ground and pound. So she's covering up here with doing my thing. She's got about 2 to 3 seconds to respond before I pin her arms or do something else. Right? So she's not protected forever. So what she's going to do is she's going to drop those elbows down to my groin. Now she's fucked with her. She's going to drop these elbows down, she fucks with her hips, face. Her both face. Right? Then I'm going to face her. Right? From here she's going to bite and interrupt it and I'm going to push. So the drill is, from here it's hitting you, drop your elbows as you buck your hips. This motion, this. You face plant, flat bite, you muscular. Do you understand, Joe? Simple. What are we using? We're using, what is this?
Secondary torus.
I'll say it's a fucking restricted strike. This one up. Yeah. And what about when I buck him up violently with my hips? I'll say that's ballistic manipulation. And when I grab him, I might come. I'm going to do that. So you see where the secondary tools are? You're using them here to reverse this mount. So, one more. Here, down, here. And this is your spot, clapping around. Let's see what she's got. That's the deal. Got it? Slightly now, there's a man you end up in this situation. Well, you could. The guy gets on top of you on a Saturday night and wants to knock you out, and this little one chokes you to death. Somebody attempts to choke your railway, it's far more sinister than trying to knock you out. Because they're showing you deadly force now, right? If you get the realization that this person is trying to kill you, depending on your personality, profile, your experience of violence, your ability to access aggression, you could capitulate.
you could actually freeze in the fact that this person's trying to do this and you just go into denial. In which case, he's going to choke you out in about 7 seconds if he knows what the fuck he's doing. Right? So your response has got to be immediate. So this is much more common to women, or even a domestically violent situation, where now I just want to throttle the bitch, because she won't do what I tell her. Right? All she's got to do is literally just bring her arms across this way, above her head, and she's going to, as best she can, drive that structure down in order to break the grip. Right? It may need be necessary for her to do that once or twice. So if I'm here choking, freeze it down. Now she brings my face in proximity to her. Do you understand? From here now she's going to index and gouge the eyes. To literally gouge. And from here she can reach around and chin grip me to reverse this position. And then she goes to this. Do you understand? When she gets up from here, just give me someone with a cup. Yeah, when you get up from this mounting position, it's Kimbo, you know the drill. Right, once she's rolled to here, and that's your inspiration when she goes to this, the best thing she can do from here is that she plant both hands on the cups, get up, and then boom! So that's what she wants to do. She wants to propel, she wants to plyometrically jump off from here. Do you understand? So it's from this position, I then to both hands, and lift my feet, and then here. Yeah, that's what she's gonna do. Right? So on top, taking the choke. Choke's position. First thing when any choke comes about, whether it's rear choke, whether it's front, whether it's standing up, whether it's on the ground, first thing you've got to do, you've got to drop your chin and shrug your shoulders. And then create a breathe space. If he knows what he's doing, both of his thumbs will be in her jugular notch. And she'll be driving in. She's got about 6 seconds. Right, so she's got to drop that, shrug that up to create a breathing space. From here, she's got to do what she can to break the structure. It might be necessary, she just pounds the forearms and hammer fist, or she gets this motion to just jerk him forward. Just that's what to create that to her arm. From there, she can index the head. So she breaks the grip, drive it down, grab the head. So as soon as she grabs the head, they go in. Right, from there, just rotate his head and get him off you. Here, now she ends up here. From here, she's going to strike the face as she can. She's going to push off the cup with both hands. Oh. Yeah. We're going to try it. You need to do a good job.
Now, obviously, if I don't cover my head, it's going to fucking rattle me and I'm going to end up on the floor anyway. But I want him to immediately get on top of me and immediately start it. I want him to try and grab me. Okay, because otherwise it's no fucking good. We're not just playing with this, yeah? We're going to try and take it as close to the street as we can get it. Let's go.
Fuck you, guys. Pass.
Get gone. Awesome. Good, didn't I? Good class.